वेलकम ऑल, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट डिस्टॉर्शन लेस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन। सो इट इज़ अ टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसमिशन लाइन इन विच द एटेन्यूएशन कॉन्स्टेंट शुड बी इंडिपेंडेंट फ्रॉम फ्रिक्वेंसी। फेज कॉन्स्टेंट दैट इज नथिंग बट बीटा शुड बी लीनियरली डिपेंड्स अपॉन द फ्रिक्वेंसी एंड द रेशियो ऑफ आर ओवर एल टू द G over C should be same. So this is the most important condition which is associated with distortionless transmission line. That is the ratio of series resistance to the series inductance should be equals to parallel conductance to the parallel capacitance. Now let us discuss about the parameters which are associated with distortionless transmission line. So the first parameter is propagation constant. That is equals to gamma. Since we know that the value of gamma is equals to under the root R plus j omega L into G plus j omega C. If we take minus j omega L common from the first bracket, then the value of propagation constant will become minus j omega L, and it become R over j omega L plus 1. And if we take minus j omega C as a common from this bracket, then it become minus j omega C and g over j omega C plus 1. Sorry, here is plus sign. That is plus j omega L and plus j omega C. Now if we take j omega L and j omega C out of this under root, then the propagation constant will become j omega under the root L C under the root R over j omega L plus 1 g over j omega C plus 1. Now if we multiply this term, that is R over j omega L, with imaginary part in both the numerator as well as with the denominator, to remove this imaginary part in the denominator. Similarly, if we multiply the numerator with j and denominator with j, the propagation constant will become j omega under the root LC under the root J multiplied with R, it become JR over this J, and J will multiply and become minus 1. So here is negative sign and omega L plus 1. And here also this J multiplied with G, and this j and j will get multiplied and become negative of omega c plus 1. Now if we rearrange this term, then the propagation constant will become j omega under the root lc under the root 1 minus jr over omega l 1 minus JG over omega C. So this is the expression that we get after rearranging this above expression. Since by the condition of distortionless transmission line, we know that R over L equals to G over C. So since R over L is equals to G over सी फॉर डिस्टॉर्शनलेस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन. वी कैन राइट दिस प्रोपोगेशन कॉन्स्टेंट एस गामा इक्वल्स टू जी ओमेगा अंडर द रूट एल सी अंडर द रूट 1 माइनस जे आर ओवर ओमेगा एल एंड 1 माइनस इंस्टीड ऑफ राइटिंग जी ओवर सी वी राइट आर ओवर एल हियर ऑल्सो सो इट बिकम जे आर ओवर ओमेगा एल. नाउ दीज टू टर्म्स आर कॉमन सो इट विल बिकम होल स्क्वायर एंड दिस होल स्क्वायर विल गेट कैंसिल्ड विद दिस स्क्वायर रूट. सो द मॉडिफाइड इक्वेशन फॉर प्रोपगेशन कॉन्स्टेंट विल बी इक्वल्स टू 1 माइनस जे आर ओवर ओमेगा एल. एंड इफ यू सेपरेट द टर्म्स देन इट बिकम गामा इक्वल्स टू जे ओमेगा अंडर द रूट एल सी प्लस आर अंडर द रूट सी ओवर एल. दिस इज द फाइनल एक्सप्रेशन फॉर द प्रोपगेशन कॉन्स्टेंट. So this is the value of propagation constant that we evaluated. Now let's move on to the next parameter, that is attenuation constant. Alpha and phase constant, that is beta. Since we know that the value of propagation constant, that is gamma, equals to alpha plus j beta. Now if we compare these both the value of propagation constant, that is alpha plus j beta, and this term, we get our real term, that is alpha, equals to r under the root c over l. And if we compare the imaginary terms, that is j beta, with this term, then we know that beta will be equals to omega under the root lc. So this alpha is nothing but attenuation constant and this beta is phase constant. Now let's move on to the next parameter, that is characteristic impedance. So the characteristic impedance is denoted by Z naught, and its expression is R plus j omega L over g plus j omega c. Now we are discussing the distortionless transmission line, and the condition for the distortionless transmission line is r over l is equal to g over c. So we have to set up this form in case of characteristic impedance. So for this we have to take j omega l common from this numerator and j omega c common from this denominator part. So taking the common, we get j omega l r plus j omega l plus 1, and from the denominator we take j omega c as a common, then it become g over j omega c plus 1. Now since we know that r over l is equal to g over c, So we will replace this g over c with r over l. So the characteristic impedance, that is Z0, become Z0 equals to under the root g omega l r over l g omega plus 1, and here is g omega c. Instead of writing g omega g over c, we write r over l. So r over g omega l plus 1. Now we cut these both terms from numerator and denominator, and this is g omega and this is also j omega. So the characteristic impedance is equals to under the root l over c, and this is the final expression for the characteristic impedance in case of distortionless transmission line. Now let us discuss the next parameter, that is phase velocity. So the phase velocity is denoted by the formula V of p equals to omega over beta. Now if we write the value of beta here, then V of p equals to omega, and here beta value is nothing but omega under the root LC. So we write omega under the root LC. This omega will get cancelled out with this omega. So the final expression for phase velocity is equals to 1 over under the root LC, and it is phase velocity. So this is all about the distortionless transmission line. If you like my videos, then do subscribe my channel and please hit the like button. Thank you.